My dear children, welcome to the EBS online class. Hope you all are staying safe at home. Today let's discuss lesson 5, Natural Resources of India. This lesson you don't have to study for exam, but we need to understand the content. What is a natural resource and which are the natural resources of India? What is a natural resource? The things that we get from nature that are of use to us are called natural resources. So can you say some of the natural resources? What all things we get from nature? Yes, air, water, sunlight, soil. All these things we get from nature. So they are natural resources. Metals, stones and wood are needed to make houses. We need petrol to run cars and buses. So they are also natural resources. We get them from nature. And they are of use to us. So they are called natural resources. Air, water, soil, sunlight, petroleum, metal, stones and wood are examples of natural resources. India is one of the richest and most diverse reserves of natural resources in the world. In this lesson, we will be learning about some natural resources. First is water. Water is a precious natural resource. From where do we get water? Most of the water that we use comes from rain and snow. This water gets collected in lakes, rivers, tanks and human-made reservoirs. Some water is also collected under the ground as groundwater. India has many tanks, rivers and lakes. Three of the largest rivers of India are Ganga, Brahmaputra and Godavari. The rivers of North India are perennial. Perennial means they are fed by melting snow and carry water throughout the year. The rivers of peninsular India are seasonal. Seasonal means they are rain fed and become dry during summer. Canals are built to channel water from one area to another. Dams are built across the rivers to hold back water and store it. Water is collected behind the dam to form a lake. This is called reservoir. Dams have many uses. Can you say some of the uses of dams? It controls flood. The water stored in the dam is also used to generate electricity and also used for irrigation. It is also used to supply water to towns and cities. Some of the important dams in India are the Indira Sagar and the Sardar Sarovar dams on the Narmada River, the Nagarjuna Sagar dam on the Krishna River, and the Bakra Nangal dam on the Satluj River. The next is soil. Soil is also an important natural resource because it is needed for growing plants, trees, and crops. Soil is the loose uppermost layer of the earth's surface. It is formed by the breaking down of rocks into sand and silt by the action of wind and water. There are many types of soil in India. They are alluvial soil, black soil, red soil, laterite soil, desert soil and mountain soil. First one is alluvial soil. It is the most fertile soil. It is formed by the deposition of silt brought down by the rivers. Alluvial soil is suited for growing rice, wheat and pulses. It is found in northern plains and coastal plains. Then next is black soil. It is formed by the breakdown of lava. What is lava? Lava is the molten material coming out from the inside of the earth during volcanic eruptions. So black soil is formed by the breakdown of lava. It is good for growing cotton and sugarcane. It is found in central and northwestern part of Deccan Plateau. Then next is red soil. It is formed by the breakdown of rocks rich in iron. Jowar, bajra and groundnut grow well in red soil. It covers large parts of peninsular plateau. Then next is laterite soil. Tea, coffee, spices, coconut, rubber grow well in laterite soil. It is found mainly in western Ghats and parts of Tamil Nadu.
Next one is desert soil. Desert soil is sandy and is not good for cultivation. But maizes, pulses and millets like jowar and bajra can be grown with the help of irrigation and by adding fertilizers to the soil. It is found mainly in Rajasthan. Last one is mountain soil. Mountain soil is rich in humus and good for growing fruits and vegetables. Fruits like peach, plum, orange, pear and apple grow well in this soil. It is found on the slopes of mountains and hills of North India.
So today we have discussed about two natural resources, water and soil. Hope you all have understood this. Read the textbook and understand well. Let's meet in the next class. Thank you.